Hi guys, in this video, I'm gonna talk about cluster analysis using PyCaret. If you have a dataset without labels, you can think of cluster analysis. Clustering is an unsupervised learning that allows us to find meaningful clusters. Each cluster shares a certain degree of similarity, but is more dissimilar to objects in other clusters. You can think of clustering as unsupervised classification. You can use this technique in many fields such as pattern recognition, image analysis, bioinformatics, machine learning, and so on. You can use PyCaret's clustering module to perform the cluster analysis. To show the clustering, I am gonna use jewelry dataset. Let's load this dataset with pandas. Let me import pandas. Import pandas as pd. I'm gonna load the dataset using the load csv method in pandas. Data equals pd.readcsv. Let me set dataset name. Okay, our dataset is loaded. The link of this dataset is in the description below. Now, let's take a look at the first rows of this dataset. Data.heat. Beautiful. You can see the first rows of the dataset. Note that the dataset has no target variable. We want to find the subgroups in dataset without labels. To do this, let's use the cluster analysis. As I mentioned in the previous videos, PyCaret is an open source library written in Python. With PyCaret, you can do the standard task in machine learning. To install PyCaret, use pip install PyCaret command. To show cluster analysis with PyCaret, first of all, let me import the PyCaret clustering module. From PyCaret.clustering import asterisk. Okay, now I'm gonna use the setup method to initialize the analysis. This function creates the transformation pipeline. S equals setup. First, let's set the name of our dataset. Data, comma. This function has a lot of parameters. To see these parameters, you can press shift and tab together. You can change these parameters according to our dataset. I want to use a normalize parameter to scan numeric features. Normalize equals true. Let me close this window. To control the randomness of the experiment, let me use the session ID parameter. Session ID, let's say 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna leave the other parameters by default. When you run this function, PyCaret will automatically infer the data types. Make sure that data types are correct. This is important for building a machine learning model. If data types are correct, you can press enter to continue. Our data types are continue, so let me press enter. You can see all preprocessing and transformation in this table. Here, you can see the descriptions and the values. There is the shape of the original data. There is no missing data in our dataset. You can check the other description and values. Wonderful! We simply finished preprocessing and transformation steps with PyCaret. To build the model, I am gonna use the create model function. This function trains and evaluates the performance of a given model. To show cluster analysis, I'm gonna use kmeans clustering. Kmeans clustering tries to minimize the sum of distances between the points and their perspective cluster centroid. Let's build a kmeans model. Kmeans equals create model. Let me set kmeans. When you run this function, you can see the metrics. These metrics are found using the getMetrics function. Cool! We built the model. Metrics evaluated can be accessed using the getMetric function. Let's take a look at the hyperparameters of this model. To do this, I'm gonna use the print function. Print, let me set kmeans. Here you go. Kmeans require the number of the clusters, which is considered to be one of the biggest drawbacks of this algorithm. Note that PyCaret automatically specified the number of clusters as 4. Awesome. Here you can see the other hyperparameters. Let's go ahead and take a look at the performance of a trained model. To do this, I'm gonna use the evaluate model function. Evaluate model. Let me set the model name. Kmeans. The evaluate model displays a user interface. To see better, let me zoom out. You can see the performance of the model using this user interface. As you can see, the cluster separated from each other very well. Here are cluster 0, cluster 1, cluster 2, and cluster 3. If you want, you can see the clusters in 3D. Let me press the cluster TCNE button. Here you go. You can play this plot as you want. Let's take a look at elbow method. Let me press the elbow button. As I mentioned, one of the biggest drawbacks for k-means is to specify the number of clusters. You can use elbow method to find the optimal number of clusters. You can decide the number of clusters by looking at the distortion scores. When these are plotted, it looks like an arm and the elbow point is the best value of k. PyCaret help you find the number of clusters. Thanks PyCaret. You can see the other plots by pressing button. You can also use the plot model function to generate plots individually. Let's take a look at the distance plot. Let me zoom in. Plot underscore model kmeans comma plot equals distance. Here you go. You can see the distance of the clusters in this plot. Using the plot model function, you can generate the other plots. You can assign cluster labels to the training data using our trained model. To do this, I am going to use the assign model function. Result equals assign underscore model kmeans. Okay, our model specified the cluster labels. Let's take a look at these labels. To do this, I am going to use the heat method. Result dot heat. Here you go. Here you can see the cluster labels. For example, the label of the first sample is cluster 1. Next, the label of the second sample is cluster 1. And so on. Okay, we solved the label for the training data. So, how does the performance of our model on the unseen dataset? To see this, I'm gonna use the predict model function. Let me set predictions equal predict underscore model kmeans comma data equal data. Beautiful. Our model predicted the labels of the unseen dataset. Let's take a look at these predictions. To do this, let me use the heat method. Predictions dot heat. Here you go. You can see the cluster labels. So far, we boot the model and then predict the labels. Now, let's save the model. To do this, I'm going to use the save model function. Save underscore model. Let me set our model kmeans. And then I'm going to write the model name. Quotation marks. Let's say kmeans pipeline. Okay. We saved the model in the working directory. You can load the model back from the working directory. To do this, let me use the load model function. Loaded underscore model equals. Let me set load model. Quotation marks. Kmeans underscore pipeline. So, we loaded the model. Print. Loaded model. Let me run this command. Here you go. That's it. In this video, I talk about cluster analysis using PyCaret. I showed you how to do the model steps for clustering. You can find the link of this notebook in the description below. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.